So first question, you played your entire career in the States, and before coming to France, of course. How did you adapt to like the format of relegation?
It took a while. From the rules, you know, still amazing to me that you can go up and swipe the ball off the rim. I think that's pretty cool. They should put that in the NBA. You know, you can stand in the key on defense. Got to put the ball on the ground before you take a step. So the rules, I had to get adjusted to the rules for a little bit. But other than that, man, we're still playing basketball. It's the same sport, same concept to put the ball in the hoop and win and play together. So, you know, for the most part, it was more of the jet lag and getting used to that. But after that, it was pretty good. After about a month, it took about a month.
So you made the playoffs all but 1 year in your ninth season career in the NBA. Is it more stressful to fight for the playoffs or to fight against relegation?
I would definitely say, you know, playoffs is definitely more intense. It's more physical. Game slows down. The possessions means much more. You know, sometimes in a regular season, you're playing 82 games. You got, you know, some players might go through the motions and take a couple nights off, but you know, in the playoffs is, you know, that's when it really comes down to, you know, real important basketball and taking care of the ball, possessions, and real physical. And I love it. I love playoff basketball.
Yeah. You just played a lot of games at home, and you're going to finish with a lot of games at home. How important is it to play with your fans?
Yeah. It's great. You know, the supporters, they're loud. You know, they're going crazy, they're making noise, they're supporting us, and you know, I enjoy it. I enjoy the fan base here. It's they're behind us whether we win or lose. You know, at home we definitely want to win. You know, we want to win all games, but especially at home we want to win, so we put a smile on everyone's faces, everyone feels good after the game.
You played against Strasbourg a couple of days ago. Mm-hmm. Tim Frazier got to this team, and he's a former teammate of yours.
Yes, my guy.
How does it feel to play against like former teammates in the NBA here in Europe?
Yeah, it feels good. I played against Ty Wallace. Me and him played with the Clippers when I played there for a little bit. He's played in Paris. So, you know, really couldn't play against Tim this time because he was hurt. But, you know, just to see those guys still getting after it. Marcus Keane, I played with him on the Wizards. He was like a two-way guy in and out of gym, but he's coming over. He's averaging 20. He's playing well. So it feels great to see players, you know, from the league come over here and still being active and still doing what they love.
You actually have like a better differential in terms of points than the two teams that are below you. Mm-hmm. Is it something that you really care, or is it just winning the games?
We just have to win. Yeah, each game, you know, right now focus on Asvel, and then we go on from there. But it's right now, you know, in our position, we can't really look ahead and look at standings and scores. And I know the coaches would do that and everyone else, but as far as players, we just got to focus on getting a win.
Now I'm going to speak a little bit about the team. When you came there, who was the guy that you saw? You was like, I didn't know that guy before, and you were amazed by his skills.
On this team?
Yeah.
I mean, I could say that for everyone. I didn't know anyone on this team, and you know, everyone's still here playing good, playing at a high level. I was kind of, I don't know, man. I thought I was going to come here and average 20, right? But, you know, this league is a lot harder than what people think and what I thought. And, man, you've got to give credit to the players and coaches in this league. And, you know, it's tough. It's still a tough league.
Yeah. So. In the entire league, who's the guy that really, like, spot your eyes and you can't say Victor because...
I'll say McDuffie from Dijon. Yeah, he's good. He's real good. He has like NBA talent, and yeah, I'll say him. I never seen him, and he's good.
Luka Doncic said that he was way harder to score in Europe. Do you feel like him? You coming up the NBA?
Yeah, NBA is more spacing. You know, like I said, you can sit in the lane here on defense, and you know, NBA, you got that 3 seconds in the defensive 3 seconds. NBA is, I think they call more fouls in the NBA, and they let you play a little bit more physical here. I agree. I mean, obviously the talent level, but you know, just to be able to sit in the zone, you know, in professional basketball, it's tough, man. It's tough. So.
and to top everything off, the NBA playoffs have started. Mm-hmm. The next one is going to start in a couple. Do you have the time to watch it? If it's a different time zone?
I watch in the mornings. Yeah. I watch in the mornings because obviously, you know, those games are, you know, 1:30 and 4 a.m. Some games, some of the morning games, they're probably like 6 and 7 p.m. here. So I like watching those. But for the most part, I just wake up in the morning, just rewatch them, watch the highlights. So yeah, I've been keeping track.
And who's your team?
I don't have a team.
Okay. Well, thank you a lot for everything, Mike.
All right, thank you.